the Oklahoman Newsroom, this is an OSU update. I'm Jenny Carlson here in studio. The Cowboys have had some struggles of late, losing four in a row in this non-conference stretch. Nathan Ruiz joins us on the phone to discuss. And Nathan, it seems like from what I read, what I gathered, that loss against Nebraska, neutral site game up in South Dakota, of all of these losses, it sure sounded like to me that Mike Boynton, that might have been the one that most disappointed him. Am I reading the Cowboy coach right on that?
I think if you read his reaction as he left for the locker room at halftime, that'd be a pretty accurate assessment. He got charged with his first technical foul. OSU ends up with its largest loss during his two-year tenure. Nebraska's a great team, so I don't want to say that OSU expected to lose, because that certainly wasn't the case. But it's a game that I think OSU definitely wanted to be more competitive in. At a neutral site, the fans in attendance there at the Sanford Pentagon in South Dakota definitely leaned Nebraska. But it's a disappointing game for OSU that now finds itself, as you mentioned, on a four-game losing streak with only two games separating it from the start of Big 12 play. So it spent seven of its first 10 games away from Gallagher-Iba Arena. They had some early wins in the year where you beat a good Memphis team, you beat a great LSU team, but since then lost to Minnesota, a loss to Tulsa, a loss to Houston, and now this loss to Nebraska. So OSU gets a chance to kind of find itself a bit, playing some lighter opponents in Central Arkansas and Texas A&M Corpus Christi. Mike Boynton has some time to fix some things, the holiday break, different things with finals and whatnot. He's been afforded some time to do some evaluation, but OSU is going to need to start seeing results on the court, and these next two opponents should give him an opportunity to do that.
Well, yeah, and these are some lighter opponents. We'll talk about this non-conference schedule in a second, but Nathan, you know, Central Arkansas in on Friday, a noon tip-off at Gallagher. That's the type of game OSU needs to win, but besides getting on the winning side, what needs to change as you've watched these Cowboys sort of hit a skid here? What needs to change to get back on the winning track, but also to get ready for Big 12 play?
Well, I think oddly it starts at the free throw line. You know, they in this four game losing streak, they're 32-61 at the free throw line, and I think in three of those four losses, their number of missed free throws exceeded the point differential. So they've wasted points at the free throw line. They're a young team, and they're turning the ball over a lot. And a big area of concern is Cam McGriff recently has struggled. He was a guy who was kind of circled as the guy coming into this year, one of their only veteran among their forwards. And after he scored 28 points against LSU, he's about matched that total in the four games since. So OSU needs to find a way to get him going. He's 2-17 in the last two games shooting. So OSU needs to find a way to get Cam McGriff shots to fall, get him relaxed, and maybe it's just possible that he's putting too much pressure on himself. They are having a couple different scores adding into the mix, with Michael Weathers joining the lineup over this season and Curtis Jones getting eligible for the first time against Nebraska. So they're able to add a little bit more scoring. They've been a great three-point shooting team. That definitely wasn't the case against Nebraska. They missed all nine of their three-point attempts in the second half. So it sounds like they just need some tweaks, getting things right. And these next two opponents definitely give him an opportunity to do that.
I know that Mike Boynton developed this non-conference schedule in large part because last year when they just missed making the NCAA tournament, there was some talk about strength of schedule. They had such marquee wins, but then didn't quite have the depth of wins that they needed to make the tournament. As you mentioned, you get some good wins out of strengthening the non-conference, but then you also have these struggles getting so close to Big 12 play. Is that kind of the double-edged sword that Mike Boynton was dealing with, and that, I don't know, has it backfired on his team a little bit?
Yeah, you worry if maybe he overcorrected when he built this schedule. As of right now, Oklahoma State's non-conference schedule ranks 14th in the nation per Ken Pom. Last season, it ranked 311th. So you jump up 300 spots, you're jumping up a huge level of competition. This OSU team is among the 50 least experienced in the country, so it's a young team going up against an immensely difficult schedule. Mike Boynton's hope is that this period of time, even if they are struggling in November and December, it's going to make them better come February and March. That's really when he, you know, hopes they're playing their best basketball. Will that happen? You know, obviously we're a couple of months away from finding that out, but you worry if he over-challenged them, if it's going to affect their psyche at all to be 4-6 through 10 games for the first time since the mid-80s. So This is an OSU team that's maybe trying to find itself a little bit, that's trying to get some of its leaders in McGriff, Lindy Waters, Tom Sazagua to step up. Both of those, you know, I mentioned McGriff struggles. Tom Sazagua struggled from three. He's been a great shooter for them this year, and that wasn't the case against Nebraska. Lindy Waters was excellent in the first half, and was pretty absent in the second half as OSU tried to find some open looks that really weren't there. So now that the schedule lightens up a bit, Central Arkansas and Texas A&M Corpus Christi are two of the three lightest opponents in their non-conference schedule to go with the season opener at Charlotte. Of course, OSU lost that game, but you figure in Gallagher-Iowa Arena, should be comfortable, should be able to get a nice couple easy wins to get back to 500 before Big 12 play starts against Iowa State on January 2nd.
Yeah, and get some confidence built back up. Obviously, opponents will get tougher, but if you feel good about how you're playing, that might go a long ways. We'll see how the Cowboys do again Friday. It's noon against Central Arkansas up in Stillwater. We'll have coverage of that and the continuing season, non-conference and conference play as that gets going here in the not-too-distant future. So be sure to stay with the best coverage team anywhere at newsok.com and every day in the Oklahoman.